In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of ligament around pelvis. There are a lot of ligaments around the pelvis. I am going to explain the posterior part first, then I will explain on the anterior part, on second part, okay? The first ligament I want to explain is this one, this white tape one. This ligament is very, very strong ligament. This ligament connects this part of ischium. This part is ischial tuberosity, and it connects to the sacrum. So this ligament is sacrotuberous ligament because that connects sacrum and ischial tuberosity. You know what? This ligament has connection with hamstrings. Some fibers of hamstrings attach on sacrotuberous ligament. That's why this ligament and hamstring has fascial connection together. So this is very, very important ligament. This is sacrotuberous ligament. The next ligament is this one, this little bit smaller one, deep to sacrotuberous ligament. This ligament connects the anterior part of the sacrum and this bony bump. This part is called the spine. So name of this ligament is sacrospinous ligament. It's deep to sacrotuberous ligament. This is sacrospinous ligament. Okay? Let's move on to next one. This beige tape. It's very broad ligament. This is posterior sacroiliac ligament because that connects sacrum and ilium. Posterior sacroiliac ligament. And some anatomy books say this whole part is sacrotuberous ligament, like this part is sacrotuberous ligament. But some anatomy books say, okay, this is posterior sacroiliac ligament. I don't think there is an obvious border between sacrotuberous ligament and sacroiliac ligament. But there is, you know, fascial connection between posterior sacroiliac ligament and sacrotuberous ligament. I don't want you to stuck on the exact precise place of anatomy. I just want you to know the general part of the ligament, and I want you to distinguish which one is which. Okay? Sacrotuberous and posterior sacroiliac ligament. Let's move on to this blue one. This blue ligament is actually located deep to sacroiliac ligament. So imagine there is sacroiliac ligament like this as well. Name of this ligament is interosseous sacroiliac ligament because it's very close to the bone. So this is interosseous sacroiliac ligament. It's very, very deep ligament. Okay? And what is this red one? This red one is supraspinous ligament. You see this bony bump, partially, this one? This is the spine on the sacrum. That's why this is supraspinous ligament. Actually, supraspinous ligament continues all the way up to cervical spine. So there is supraspinous ligament on lumbar spine, on the thoracic spine, and on the cervical spine. Okay, this is just on the sacral part. Let's move on to the coccyx. Okay, there are few ligaments on coccyx and sacrum. This one is posterior sacrococcygeal ligament. There is superficial part and deep part, this midline part. This lateral part is superficial part of sacrococcygeal ligament. This midline part is the deep part of sacrococcygeal ligament. Okay, coccyx actually has a lot of ligament, like this tiny green one. This one is lateral sacrococcygeal ligament because it's on the more on the lateral side compared to this posterior sacrococcygeal ligament. Okay, this is lateral sacrococcygeal ligament. Okay, this is pretty much the posterior part of the ligament. If you want to be very, very, very specific, there are many other ligaments, but these ligaments are basically the main ligaments around posterior part of pelvis. Okay, let's review on the posterior part. This is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrotuberous ligament. And this deep one is sacrospinous ligament. This beige tape is posterior sacroiliac ligament. And deep to posterior sacroiliac ligament, there is interosseous sacroiliac ligament. This red one is supraspinous ligament. It goes all the way to the cervical spine. And this yellow-green stripe color is posterior sacrococcygeal ligament. This midline one is deep part of sacrococcygeal ligament. And this green one is lateral sacrococcygeal ligament. Oh my gosh, there are a lot of ligaments. Now let's go to the anterior part of the pelvis. Okay, now you are looking pelvis from anterior part. Let's see, let's go to this black one. This black one is the inguinal ligament. Inguinal ligament. This is very, very superficial part. Let's change angle. So it's very, very superficial connective tissue. What is important about inguinal ligament? There are many muscles, nervous tissues, and blood vessels pass posterior to inguinal ligament. So if somebody has the weakness here, it can affect nervous tissue, blood vessels, and muscle posterior to this ligament, okay? Inguinal ligament. And let's go to this yellow one. You know what? Actually, this is not a pubic symphysis of the pelvis. Pubic symphysis is that you see the clear tissue deep to this, that's pubic symphysis. But this yellow tape is the ligament. This is pubic ligament. There are four parts of pubic ligament. This is anterior part, and this is inferior part, and this is superior part. And let's flip it, and there is a posterior part of pubic ligament. Actually, the superior part and inferior part are the stronger one. Anterior part and posterior part are not that strong. So, inguinal ligament and pubic ligaments. There are four parts on the pubic ligament. Okay, let's go to the deeper part. This red one, this is anterior longitudinal ligament. This ligament is very, very long ligament. Like a supraspinous ligament, anterior longitudinal ligament goes all the way up to cervical spine as well. So there's continuation all the way up to cervical spine. Anterior longitudinal ligament. And let's go closer view. You see the yellow-green stripe one. This is anterior sacrococcygeal ligament. Anterior sacrococcygeal ligament. This ligament is quite unique. It crosses midline. It runs like diagonally and crosses midline. This is very interesting, I think. There are not much ligaments that crosses midline. There are pubic ligaments cross midline, but this ligament is kind of horizontal, right? Compared to anterior sacrococcygeal ligament, it runs diagonally and crosses. I think this orientation is quite interesting. And last one, this beige tape. This beige tape is anterior sacroiliac ligament. We had posterior sacroiliac ligament. We have anterior sacroiliac ligament. So review of anterior part. This black one is inguinal ligament. Many vessels and nervous tissue run posterior to inguinal ligament. This yellow one is pubic ligament. There are four parts of pubic ligament. Superior, inferior, anterior, and posterior. This red one is anterior longitudinal ligament. And you see the striped one? That's anterior sacrococcygeal ligament. That ligament crosses midline. Very unique. And this is anterior sacroiliac ligament. Oh my gosh! There are a lot of ligaments around pelvic girdle. I know remembering anatomy is very, very hard to do, especially in the first part. But I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy, you know, looking the colorful tapes. So if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.